here, you'll notice that they're all in one text box, but I've changed the order of things, and this particular one has a different color. So how did I do that? Well, I did it basically by capitalizing. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to split up text boxes so that you can apply different formatting to different sections of things like Bible references. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever wanted like different parts of text to have different formatting and kind of do that automatically, go ahead, like, subscribe, and tell me about it in the comments below. This came from someone asking a question in the official ProPresenter users community. He was like, I want to be able to have different formatting for the name of the book versus the chapter and verse. How can I do that in ProPresenter? And the immediate reaction from people was, well, you can't. But that's not exactly true. So let's head over to the computer and let me show you what I came up with. Now, I will tell you, this isn't easy. It's not like, oh yeah, do one checkbox and then therefore it works, but it is possible to do. So here in ProPresenter, this is basically what he wanted to do. Notice the translation is yellow here. The chapter and verse is on top, and then the actual book is down below. And if we right-click and go to edit the slide here, you'll notice that they're all in one text box, but I've changed the order of things, and this particular one has a different color. So how did I do that? Well, I did it basically by capitalizing on how the reflow editor works. So let's head over to the Bible here and let's look up, let's do my funny life first. So Acts 26, 24, this is one I found my freshman year of college. After my first week, the campus pastor told me when I said that I'd been studying so much it was driving me crazy. He goes, yeah, that's in the Bible. And that is, suddenly Festus shouted, Paul, you are insane. So much learning is driving you mad. Acts 26, 24. So you can't really read that there. But let's go in. First off, we're going to add this back here into this. So I can go down here to save. And let's add it to the selected presentation, which is the John 3:16 presentation. Now I can go back into show mode. And having done that, it's this one right here. Let's go into the reflow editor. Click on reflow here, and you'll see that we've got it right here. So the first thing, first off, I don't know why my thumbnails aren't updating. I'm sure that's something that I need to reach out to Renewed Vision about. But with any block of text, the first thing that you can do is you can click wherever you want to split it up into two text boxes and either click on Insert Slide Breakdown here, or on a Mac, hold down Option and tap Return. On Windows, Control Enter. So once you do that, you have it on two different slides. So what you can do at that point is just you can go back here and let's right click on it and go to themes, and I'm gonna apply this theme right here. So having done that, you'll notice that this shows up like this and this shows up like this. So they've got different formatting for both of them here. And now I can go back into Reflow Editor, and I can click back here. And
do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person.
Actually, probably what I would want to do is let me change the formatting not only of the text box, because I think that what's going to happen is when I combine this, this is going to go back into that same text box. So I'm going to actually, let me just edit this slide, and let's make it obvious that I've done this, the too much crazy. And let's just make it pretty big, and let's change this to italic, and let's make it bold, and let's make it all caps, just so that it's obvious when we combine. So now we go back here into Reflow Editor, and I click the beginning of it, and then I can go back. And when I've done that, you'll notice that it did update here. And so, going back into show mode here, I've got the totally different formatting here. So, basically what I did for these is, first off, I made sure that the Reflow would target the appropriate text box. In order to do the reference, the text box needs to be the biggest text box. So what I could do is I could just go into the editor here and make this a bigger text box. And notice when I go into Reflow for it, now Acts of the Apostles is the one that it's targeting because it's the biggest text box. That's very manual, and I could have just manually in the editor done that. But what would be another way that I could do that? Well, I could have a theme that changes the size of the text box of the reference to where it's the larger of the two text boxes. So I apply the theme, makes it larger. Go into Reflow, split it up. Split it up everywhere I want. So if I wanted Acts of the Apostles to be different, split it up again, Option Return on my Mac keyboard, or Control Enter on Windows, or Insert Slide Break. And if I wanted to split up these two things, just repeat it one more time. And now go back into show mode and then apply the appropriate theme to each of those for the reference. So here, no reference. And I could just then apply the appropriate theme for those text boxes and have it show up correctly that way. So that's basically what I did up here See, I tried it a couple of different ways to make it work, but this did in fact do what I wanted. With the theme, I moved the translation up to the top, I moved the chapter and verse to the middle, and then I moved the words down to the bottom. I could move those anywhere I want. I just basically did that with themes after I split them up. And then, having split them up, I went back and I recombined them back together. And that's how they all ended up in the same text box. So that is how you can take advantage of the Reflow editor in order to get the text boxes to work in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.